Eternal light, shine in our hearts. Eternal wisdom, scatter the darkness of our ignorance. Eternal compassion, have mercy on us. Turn us to seek your face, and enable us to reflect your goodness through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
A reading from Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, see you are humble with garments for Judah, and pray and raise hearts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, O Lord, your people, the remnant of Israel. See, I am going to bring them from the land of the north, and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth. Among them, blind and the lame, those of child and those in labor, a great company, they shall return here. With weeping they shall come, and with consolations I will lead them back. I will let them walk by brooks of water, in a straight path in which they should not suffer stumble. For I have become a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. The word of the Lord.
Today's gospel reading is about more than a blind man receiving his sight. In that story we just heard, first, the blind man did have a name. He was a person, and his name was Bartimaeus. Second, he was the sign of the road where Jesus was leaving Jericho, begging for money in order to live. And then when Jesus healed him, Bartimaeus received his sight. And if this was the whole story, it would simply be a story of Jesus healing someone. But in fact, when you read the story closely, there is so much more. Infused throughout this story is the language of faith. From the very beginning, unlike so many other people in the Gospel of Mark who wonder who Jesus is, from the very beginning, Bartimaeus knows who Jesus is. Son of David, have mercy on us. Have mercy on me. Now those words are familiar to us. You may remember in some seasons of the church, we sing what we call the Kyrie. And in the Kyrie, we repeatedly sing, Lord, have mercy on me. And in singing that, we are putting ourselves in the sandals. That is, we are putting ourselves in the very place of Bartimaeus. Not because we're blind, but because, like Bartimaeus, we need and we call out for God's mercy for us and God's mercy for the world. And it is in Jesus that we meet the Son of David. David, the ancient king, 1,000 years before Jesus and Bartimaeus. David, the ancient king, 3,000 years before us. David, despite terrible sin, was still beloved by God. David was so beloved by God that God promised that his kingship would endure eternally throughout his descendants. This kingship through David's descendants, it had huge gaps without any king. And the God promised Davidic kingship was even unfulfilled for century after century during the ongoing events of history. Until in Bethlehem, in the city of David, an obscure child was born in a manger. Instead of a regal, powerful, earthly king like David long ago, Jesus was born. And remember, every Christmas we even sing along with the angels, glory to the newborn king. Remember that? Jesus, the infant king, born in obscurity, grew up to become an ordinary looking teacher and preacher who nevertheless was the Son of David and the Son of God. And so was Bartimaeus. It was the man who was blind, who could see with eyes of faith, even in his darkness, that Jesus of Nazareth was the long-promised king. Bartimaeus asked to receive his sight. Jesus gave the man his sight. But even that's not the end. We hear that Bartimaeus then followed Jesus on the way. Bartimaeus followed Jesus on his way to Jerusalem, where the cross and the tomb awaited him. Even more than healing, Bartimaeus literally became a follower of Jesus. Jesus transformed Bartimaeus from a beggar along the side of the road to a follower who walked the road with Jesus to Jerusalem and the cross. And there, outside the walls of Jerusalem, the cross of Christ cancels sin. The cross and empty tomb conquers death. And the Son of David, through his death and resurrection, changes the world. The Son of David changes the world by pouring out God's mercy. Now, even 2,000 years after Bartimaeus calling out for mercy, and Jesus pouring out God's mercy from the cross and empty tomb, now, even 2,000 years later, when we sing that thing we call the Kyrie, calling out to the Lord in song, we are still seeking God's mercy. Mercy not only for ourselves, but mercy for the whole world. Not just Bartimaeus, but both we and the world need God's mercy. We need God's mercy because, in the words of St. Paul, we fall short of the glory of God. Our lives are wounded by sin. There is nothing we can do to earn God's favor. And meanwhile, our world dysfunctionally careens from one crisis to the next tragedy. And still, God has already had mercy on us. God not only restored sight years ago to Bartimaeus along the side of the road, even now God loves us in the faith. And God takes people like Bartimaeus and even us, who otherwise would live on the edge of the road, and God makes us followers of the King. And now, as followers of Jesus today, let us join Bartimaeus. Let us join him and cry out and sing out in prayer for Christ's mercy for us and God's mercy for the whole world and all its people. So I'd like you right now to take out the red hymnal. I would like you to turn down to page 138 in the front of the hymnal. And sorry, folks, the cars, it didn't occur to me until now that you wouldn't have a hymnal before you, but you probably know this, knowing the people out of the cars. Page 138. We're going to close this portion by singing the Kyrie together. I will sing the parts of plain print, and then you will respond to what's in bold print, but it's been a little while, so we're going to rehearse your part for just a second. You're going to sing Lord Have Mercy. So, Audrey, give me an F. Thank you. Repeat after me. Lord, have mercy. Let's do it again. Lord, have mercy. Okay, now we're going to do this. Audrey, I've lost my ball of pitch. Could you play a C for me? Thank you. Okay, ready? In peace, let us pray to